all you metal maniacs, this is Rob, the painkiller Halford, from Judas Priest, and you're watching M. Cease and Rock and Hard. Judas Priest is a new drummer called Scott Travis. He's from America, would you believe, which now makes us an Anglo-American heavy metal group, whatever that means. The fact is that the guy's an absolutely sensational drummer. He was the best drummer that we could find to play the kind of music that we were making, especially for Painkiller. And he's a heavy metal freak. He's totally into Judas Priest. And it's like a dream come true for him, because when he was in bands when he was a teenager, all they ever used to play was Judas Priest songs. So you can imagine how this guy feels. It's a very unique moment for him. But he's made a great contribution to Judas Priest, as much as all the drummers have in Judas Priest. We've had a few drummers in this band, but they've all had something very unique and very special to offer. And I think that what Scott has done for Judas Priest is given us a lot of energy and a lot of excitement and a lot of power that has enabled us to go musically into different areas that we haven't been able to venture into with the previous guys that have worked in the band. This is a public service announcement to the parents of heavy metal maniacs all over France and all over the rest of the world, if you get to see this eventually. You must listen to what your heavy metal offspring are getting into. This is simply heavy metal music. It's nothing weird, it's nothing strange, it's nothing bizarre, it's nothing dangerous. It's just another form of music that's a great release and a great form of entertainment and enjoyment. So I think that you should buy a copy of Judas Priest Painkiller for yourself and for all of the relatives in your family, and buy a copy for the dog if you have one. And if you have goldfish, buy a copy for the fish so you can play the music. This will just go to prove that it's just great music. See, Judas Priest, and I was going to have to describe, almost like a travel agent, Judas Priest's surroundings. Imagine concrete, cement. Imagine steel girders. Imagine pollution. Imagine litter. Imagine dog shit on the streets. Imagine incredible working class people that work really hard and have great heart and spirit. Imagine lots of steel, lots of iron, lots of smoke, lots of grime. Imagine Monsters of Rock from the Ram It Down album, and that would be my description for the hometown of Judas Priest. And it's a great place to spend a vacation. The only thing I can possibly conceive of coming out for Judas Priest from the Midlands, from the heart of this industrial, it's not a wasteland, some people say it is, but I could only imagine heavy metal music. Can you imagine Judas Priest sounding like Kylie Minogue? It wouldn't work. It's got to be pure, solid, powerful, dominating, aggressive, exciting, energizing heavy metal music. Nothing else. I think a lot of people think of the Midlands and Birmingham, where we come from, as being almost the centre of the heavy metal universe, because when we began in the early 70s, the only other band of any real prominence was Black Sabbath. And of course, Robert Plant came from the Birmingham region with Led Zeppelin. And so I guess, again, because of the environment, you know, it can only be perceived as a place that this kind of music would come from. I think that environment and the structure of the place that you come from and that you live in has a strong relevance on the way you turn out as a person and the kind of music that you play. So Birmingham and the Midlands will always be heavy metal. The Midlands heavy metal capital of the universe. There's a rumour that the band Judas Priest originated around 1969, which is a long, long time ago, and there were then only, I think there may be two or three people originally thought of the concept of the name and the beginnings of Judas Priest. The then singer, the then drummer, I don't know who was the guitar player or who was the bass player, but anyway, that's where it came from. Sometime, we believe, in 1969. It could have been the year, I don't know, just after the dinosaurs were extinct, which is what some people always refer to heavy metal music as, though, which is a load of rubbish. Because heavy metal music will last a lot longer than the dinosaurs did, I'll tell you that now. So Judas Priest started a long, long time ago, when Europe was still probably part of the Ice Age, and we came along, and when the metal started, everything started to get really hot and melting. And so here we are in the year 1990, and still surviving with the name of Judas Priest. People that will hate and dislike heavy metal music, and they will always look at us as being strange and evil and nasty and menacing and have all the bad connotations that they can believe or desire to construct about this name and about this band. And I would much rather it be that way than anything else in the world, because I would rather be in a band that has a name that stimulates people, that maybe annoys people, makes people think, than anything else. But if you'd have told me that Judas Priest was going to go through hell in the year 1990, at least the first middle part of 1990, if you'd have told me that years ago, I don't think I would have believed it. But as you know, and as we know, that's something that we've just been through. And it's been very difficult. So we've had a lot of confrontations with the name Judas Priest and what it means to some people, particularly in the United States of America. And it's a problem that we've had to deal with, but we came out on top, as you now know. We won that trial in Reno, and it makes us feel good, not only for Judas Priest, but for heavy metal music and for heavy metal fans all over the world. So, Mr. Halford, what's all this about? And what's all this and this and this and this? And these are the kinds of questions that journalists ask you, you know, critics ask you. Well, the truth is, as we approach the year 2000, I'm planning to do something very spectacular and very original and very different and very strange and very bizarre. And this and all this is part of this plan that I'm creating right now. So we have to wait 9 more years, but eventually we shall find out what it is that's going to happen. It's an exciting prospect, isn't it? Or not? And while we're on the subject of this and this and this, what are you asking me? Is this strange symbol? Is this some kind of deep, dark, mysterious, malevolent symbol that he has round his neck? Well, if you look on the Sad Wings of Destiny album cover, you'll see around the angel this particular pendant. This is the Judas Priest symbol. This is the devil's tuning fork.
sun.
The critics. The critics.
The critics.
The ever-present critics are saying that Painkiller is what Priest is all about. Well, of course, we agree with that 100%. Fact is that art will always be criticised, heavy metal will always be criticised, and people will say this is better than the last album, or they should make a sound that this is more representative, or da 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 da. And so, what do you say about Painkiller? To me, Painkiller has simply a lot of the qualities of all the representations of Judas Priest that I know of, right from the early days, obviously up until the present, and including some of the feeling of more of the recent types of heavy metal music. So while I was in Reno, Nevada, which is close to Las Vegas, they have all these shows, you know, like cabaret acts and lounge acts and Tom Jones and Engelbert Humperdinck. And so Engelbert came up to me while I was there and he said, "Rob, would you like to do a duet?" You know. And I said, "Eng, baby. Eng. I'm sorry. But I could never, ever see myself doing anything other than what I do in Judas Priest, and that is being a screaming metal maniac. That's my first love. It always will be my first love. And I couldn't possibly perceive of myself doing anything else." Can you imagine? Living after midnight, rocking to the dawn. It just doesn't work, does it? I mean, you know, you just need these screaming guitars and smoke and explosions. You've got to go for that, and that's what I'm all about.